You are listening to Advent Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Stay tuned.
We will wait upon the Lord. His presence is fullness of joy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Saturday, the 18th of December, 2021, third week of Advent, and we are on the second day of our immediate preparation for Christmas, this last week, and the third day of our Christmas novena. Today we are confronted with a word that gives us strength. It is the word that tells us that no matter how long it may take, injustices may not last long. No, God will intervene in his own time. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who are weighed down from of old by slavery beneath the yoke of sin, may be set free by the newness of the long-awaited nativity of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Margaret Busulwa, celebrating her birthday today, a Daily Bread member from Kampala, Uganda.
First reading, I'll raise up for David a righteous branch. A reading from the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah 23:5-8. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I'll raise up for David a righteous branch, and he shall reign as king and deal wisely, and shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In his days, Judah will be saved, and Israel will dwell securely. And this is the name by which he will be called: the Lord is our righteousness. Therefore, behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when men shall no longer say, as the Lord lives, who brought up the sons of Israel out of the land of Egypt, but as the Lord lives, who brought up and led the descendants of the house of Israel out of the north country and out of all the countries where he had driven them. Then they shall dwell in their own land. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Valerius Kosikojo, a Daily Bread member and a spirit and missionary working in all diocese, Ghana.
Jesus was born of Mary, the betrothed of Joseph, a son of David. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 1, reading from verses 18 to 24. The birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child of the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to send her away quietly. But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord has spoken by the prophet. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us begin with the first reading of today, the book of Jeremiah. And it is good for us to understand the context of this book. Jeremiah lived during a very difficult political period in the history of his people. It was about the end of the 7th century, that is about 600 years before Christ. The pious king Josiah had been killed during a terrible battle and power taken by his son Jehoiakim. This son was not like his father. He was corrupt, liked lavishness, and instead of looking after the interests of the poor among his people, he built splendid palaces for himself, as many of our leaders do in the world. When their focus is on enriching themselves, they build mansions that they will not even use. They build houses which are irrelevant. They are not even going to use the rooms which are there, just to show that they have money. And you know, he did exactly that. He let the innocent be oppressed and the wicked go free. Politically, he was very unwise. He allied himself with Egypt and defied the powerful king of Babylon, Nebuchadnezzar, who defeated him easily. He died only a few years later and was succeeded on the throne by his son, who reigned only for 3 years and was then imprisoned by Nebuchadnezzar, who put in his place a person of his own choice, that is Zedekiah. But what we see during all this period was selfishness on the part of leaders, selfishness on the part of shepherds, who ended up making wrong choices, and those wrong choices affected innocent people. The people of Israel were taken into exile in 587 BC, and it is against this background that Jeremiah comes to write to the people by first of all castigating the shepherds, the rulers. Woe to the shepherds who mislead and scatter the flock of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, against the shepherds who shepherd my people, you have scattered my sheep and driven them away. You have not cared for them, but I will take care to punish your evil deeds. I myself will gather the remnants of my flock from where they have been scattered. These are the preceding verses that we have before reaching the verses we read today. The Lord decides to take up the task of restoration, the task of gathering all those who had been scattered because of the selfishness, all those who went into exile because of the selfishness of the leaders who were supposed to take care of the people of God. They focused too much on themselves that they forgot about the sheep, about the flock. The Lord says, I'm starting a process of gathering, and that process of gathering will end in the coming of my only son, my beloved son, Jesus Christ, who will be the real shepherd, who will be the shepherd of my people. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up for David a righteous branch. It is like the trees had become rotten. The trees which were supposed to give a shade to people were no longer growing. By that we mean the shepherds. They were no longer displaying the qualities of a shepherd. And so the Lord himself promises that he's going to do something. He will raise up a righteous branch. It will be just a branch, not the whole tree. And that branch is sufficient. And that branch will become the Lord is our righteousness. In a society that had lost righteousness, in a society where what is right depended on what a person was thinking was right, we needed the Lord our righteousness. Christ came as the Lord our righteousness to restore sanity in a world that had lost value. And this world is still here. The world where anything is okay. The world where we see people reacting when a law is passed that there will be no more abortion in one of the states of the United States of America. And I really thank God that there is still sanity in America. People are able to defend life from conception and say no abortion. And others are reacting. Those who are on the opposite end of the moral spectrum are reacting that this has happened. We see people seeing anything okay. Even killing seems to be okay. And here we need the sanity to be restored by the Lord our righteousness. We need the sanity to be restored in our family lives, where people seem to think that it is normal to have small houses apart from my spouse. It is normal for a man to misbehave. It is normal. We need the Lord our righteousness to come and restore the fact that it is husband and wife and nothing more. We need to restore our sanity in people who think that being drunk every day is normal, where you don't even have a sense of direction in your life, we start thinking it's normal. It's not normal. We need the Lord our righteousness to restore sanity. And this Lord promised is the one we see in the gospel passage of today. We are told how it came about, that he was born. This is how it came about. Because in order for the Lord our righteousness to come into the world, he needs to find somebody righteous to work in him, to work in her. And Joseph was that person. And Mary was that person. Joseph, hearing the shocking news of Mary being pregnant when he had never touched her, decided to send her away quietly because he was a righteous man, because he was a just man. A just man is one who learns not to publish the evils of others. A just man is one who is patient. A just man is somebody who takes his time to react, to respond to a situation. He had to sleep over it. He decided to send her away quietly. And while he was making that decision, it wasn't a decision made in haste. No, it was a decision made in patience and endurance. Oh, we need so many Josephs in our lives today. We need so many Josephs in both men and women. I find a message in the phone of my spouse, and the first thing I want to do is to let the whole world know. And the first thing I want to do is to react there and then. You'll be disappointed to find out that what you are thinking is not actually the case. Things are not always as they seem to be. We should be careful when we are deciding on something. Let us be the Josephs of our time. Righteous men and women who are able to take their time to take a decision. Because when you take your time to make a decision, you'll be guided by the Lord. He had to sleep over it. And in the dream, the angel appeared to him and explained to him what was really happening. Unreasonable as it sounded, but God worked wonders through that. And God is going to work wonders in your life when you learn patience, when you learn not to react to situations and wait. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Saturday to you.
Thanks be to God.